Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to Ron Cooming. And the Internet Marketing and Business Solution Radio Show, 980 WCAP. We're here every Monday from 11 to 12 p.m. to bring you actionable methods and solutions to increase and enhance your success for Internet marketing and your overall business performance. My name is Ronald Cooming from RCS Technology Solutions. I am your host. Our call-in number is 978-454-4980, and my business number is 978-606-5432. What I'd like to talk to you about now, this is what I'd like to call the educational section of the show. I basically give you actionable tips on things you can do to increase your internet marketing. Today, I'd like to talk to you about three tips to increase your digital marketing, and the first one is to talk to you about the value of increasing your investment in social media. It seems like every single person on the planet is using social media, doesn't it? Well, we're not quite there yet, but we're very, very close. So using social media to increase your community base, you don't want to just be posting posts on social media. You want to use it as an engagement tool. You want to ask questions. What is, how are you doing, or anything like this, so people are responding. And also, to successfully market your social media or products on social media, you will need to increase the amount of money and time you spend on social media marketing and advertising. It's just necessary. Everybody else is doing it. If you're not, your competitors are going to get out in front of you. The good news is, with metrics on Facebook, you can actually limit who you are advertising to. You could advertise to your audience very, very minutely. You could say business owners who like Tony Robbins, and you know, whatever it is, they like archery on the weekends, and you can limit down. You can start your field, and you can create what they call an audience inside Facebook, and you can start that with simply zip codes. So everybody in a zip code that is a business owner, or that is a CEO, or that is married. If, let's say, you own a bridal shop. So maybe it would be somebody who's recently engaged. So they would automatically see your post. Anybody who just announced that they were recently engaged. So you might go from 10,000 people in that zip code down to 4. Now your ads, you're going to post your ads for $20, but guess what? Only those 4 people are going to see it. So the way Facebook and other social media platforms have done their matrix, you can really fine-tune your marketing. So when I say increase your marketing, it doesn't have to be thousands of dollars, especially if you do it smarter. And also think about launching a new podcast. Believe it or not, podcasts are excellent digital marketing tools. This is because there are millions of Americans that faithfully listen to a number of podcasts on a weekly basis. If you don't have the time and don't want to start your own podcast, you can always look into advertising on one that covers topics that are closely related to your products or services. In future episodes, I'm going to be talking about influence marketing and how to connect with people who do influence marketing. And by that, I mean, if you find somebody who has 150,000 followers and you somehow connect with them, in our business we call that like joint venturing, but if you somehow connect with them, or you put a post, a comment, you don't want to, if they're selling something or they put up something on their website, an article or something, you don't want to overtake whatever they put up. But if you can contribute to the conversation with a link to another blog or something that you did, that's appropriate. But never overtake the person who actually put that post up. But that way there, people, that person has 150,000, 50,000, 200,000, whatever their followers are, all those people who are in that feed, they get to see your content, your name, and they might just click on it. So that's what we call influence marketing and engaging with them. We will go into more detail. I'll do a whole segment on that. And another thing, my third tip, is to develop a video ad. As you heard our earlier speaker today, Megan Corson, speak about. Developing a video will dominate the world of internet marketing in 2016. Already happening. In 17, it's only going to be more. By 2020, as I told you earlier, Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook believes 70 to 80% of all posts on Facebook are going to be videos. Google predicts that 70% of all, when somebody's typing in a search query right now, you might come up with blog articles. However, Google has already predicted by that approximately 2020, 70% of every single search query is going to result in some video. So you have to get ahead of that video marketing. So you want to make sure that your brand or business joins this movement. Keep in mind that there are no longer any need to spend lots of money on the production of professional quality ads or commercials. In fact, you could shoot a simple video from a smartphone with high quality video recordings. Many consumers actually prefer this form of casual video marketing because it shows more personal side of the brand. Now that's true going forward, but for your introduction video, your About Us video, and also videos related to if you're doing a course, an online course, educational videos, you really don't want them to be haphazard. You want professionally done videos as most as possible. Megan, we have a few more minutes. Can you tell us a little more about that? Here we have Megan Corson from Flash 22 Productions back with us again. Thanks, Megan.
Awesome. Thank you, Ron. I'm happy to give even more insights to you guys. So again, I give guidance for people to how to DIY their video marketing, whether you're using a smartphone, you have a video camera, and you want to become go from a dabbler to becoming more of an expert. I actually guide people step-by-step through that, too, in consulting in an online course that I provide for people of how to do video marketing from scratch. And I show people how to work with an expert, and I even provide those expertise if you guys choose to go with Flash 22 Productions. But the key is you really need to go with a purpose when you do video, regardless if you do it yourself or work with the professional, so you can get the most out of your investment of your time and your budget that you put into it.
That's great advice, Megan. And again, I had mentioned the three videos or four videos, series of videos that should be professionally done. And I agree with that. I have them myself. I'm not just talking the talk. But in terms of more casual videos, could you tell us a little bit about Facebook Live and what would be appropriate on there product and service-wise and what might not be better served there?
Yes. Yeah, so what would work for, say, Facebook Live or any more casual videos online, like say with your smartphone, it's really depending on how you position yourself with your business. So for example, if you're an expert coach or speaker or you're your brand, then that works to your favor because people want to get to know you and feel like they know you, and then they're going to want to do business with you. If you keep on staying top of mind, that's the key. That's why it's so great to be on social media and getting on there with videos, because you're just constantly staying on top of mind so that people don't forget you, people don't forget Ron, people don't forget me, Megan. It's key to stay top of mind. And for people who are afraid to go in front of the camera, I literally give consulting and guidance for that, because it's all about building confidence, and I help people bring out their true selves and feel good and great in front of the camera. I take my experience from being a news reporter to being in front of the camera and behind the camera, and I help people do that so they can do that for the rest of their career and not have to feel like they always have to go to a professional.
Yeah, and I think that's great. Earlier we had spoken about price points, and Megan just clarified that. Earlier when we spoke about price points, Megan's price point is not $10,000. That's what a lot of Fortune 500 companies and bigger companies like Coca-Cola might pay. A company like ours, starting out, been in the business 4 or 5 years, they might pay $2,500, $3,000, $3,500. So it's really cost affordable, and what it gives you going forward is a tremendous value. Megan, you have anything else you'd like to add?
Yes, and just the key is to keep in mind that it's an investment. Video lasts forever unless if you radically change the direction of your business. You can shoot a series of videos, and those videos can last to your business for several years, not just 1 year. So just compare that to other budgets that you're creating in your marketing and how it's only month to month or week to week. Videos have a very long shelf life when you do them right. So that's why I recommend going with a pro.
Yep, I think that's excellent, Megan. And again, just giving you ideas for your social, to increase your digital marketing, some very quick ideas. And again, you can go to my website and see much more in-depth analysis on my blogs, rcstechnologysolutions.com, and then just go to the blog section. But three tips on increasing your digital marketing is to increase your investment on social media marketing, launch a podcast, and develop a video ad. These are all things that will help you short and long term. This is Ron Cooming from RCS Technology Solutions. You've been listening to the Internet Marketing and Business Solution radio show on 980 WCAP. Have a great week.